Welcome back. If you watched our last video, you saw us catching these rios out at a drainage canal on my way home from work. By the way, if you have a vacuum breaker on your hose, you get soaking wet every now and then. So you watched us catch these rios using the cane pole. Today we're going to do something a little special. I'm going to show you how to fillet them, and then we're going to make fish jerky out of these fish. Make sure you hit that subscribe button down below so you don't miss out on any of our new videos. Also, you'll be entered into our giveaway when we reach 100 subscribers, and it'll have a reel, some baits, things like that. Also, you don't want to miss out on any of our new content. Let's get these fish filleted. I'm going to show you how to make jerky out of them. Difficult than I realized to clean. Alright, so after you get that done, its rib cage actually comes way up here. So I'm gonna make that cut, make that cut. But look at that meat, guys. Look, it's like got like a blue tint to it. How awesome is that? So from what I hear with these, I don't know how much meat we're gonna get off them little guys, but we'll cook them up. So from what I hear, these fish actually, Where they're native to, they actually are some of the best tasting fish. Like, that's their target species when they go out for fish. And as tough as their skin is, guys, it makes it easy to fillet it off of the skin. I mean, but as you can see, they just got a bluish tint to it. That is cool. I mean, here, and this is if, see how this one I cut it, accidentally cut it off. What I did was I cut the rib cage out, so I filleted the rib cage off, and then it gives you a nice place to put your hand and finish filleting that meat off. You don't get a lot off these fish, so I'm hoping they're good. I'm gonna have to definitely watch them while I'm cleaning, while I'm cooking them. Alright, I'm going to get the rest of these filleted up, and we'll be back and I'll show you what we're going to make as a seasoning for the jerky. Alright guys, so I'm actually going to take some more fish out because that piece of fish ain't going to feed nobody that I know. So, yeah, this is the largest piece we have off of them fish, so we're going to go take some more fish out. I might take some of the trout we caught out in the Grand Isle video, bank fishing. Check that video out here. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is power it on. We are going to select 180 and press ignite. Alright, it's going to start to ignite. You already see the temperature is 90 degrees because it's hot out here, so my sous chef here, Toulouse, you don't want to be on camera. My sous chef there actually unplugged my grill, so it threw me for a loop, guys. About having the Traeger with Wi-Fi is that I can go inside and my phone will actually tell me when it's preheated, so we're going in. Now, we're going to go ahead and get it, the fish seasoned, so that as soon as it's preheated, we can put it on. Because it's going to have to go on the thing for about 5 hours. So I like a dry rubbed blend when I do it, instead of marinating. And I'm using some sweet heat for your meat. I love this. The only thing, I'm cutting it a little bit instead of putting straight sweet heat for your meat. I'm cutting it with brown sugar. I put about 1-to-1. You can mix it up, trade it. I'm going to leave a link in the comments below with their website. I've known Mr. Charlie for years. He's a great man. Definitely try it out. You won't be disappointed, I promise. So I'm actually not going to use my grill racks. I have these are cookie cooling racks I like to use. So we're just gonna put it in there. Get it covered as best as possible and set it on the cookie cooling rack. And also, the reason I like using the cookie cooling racks is because these would probably fall through the rack on the grill. Alright, so all of the Rios are battered up. Or have the rub on them. Let me go see if the specks and the catfish are dried out, and we'll start putting them on the other half here. Alright, so the speckled trout is thawed. And, like I said, the speckled trout was caught, if you watched the video. I'll actually put it in the link while I'm doing this. I'll have it pop up on the screen. The video where me and my buddy Shane went out to Grand Island and did some bank fishing. These are the specks that were caught. He caught one, I caught one. Just sprinkling a little bit on top just to make sure it's evenly coated. Alright, so if you notice, it turned more into a paste now instead of a dry. And that is because we did not dry the fish before we did it, but so what I'm going to do for that last piece is just kind of sprinkle a little bit of You know, it helps if you open the top of the sweet heat for your meat. I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit across the top. I'm going to show you actually how to do this. I put some sweet heat for your meat. And then I have dark brown sugar. I'm eyeballing it, but it's about 1 to 1. Which the sweet heat for your meat actually does have brown sugar in it, I believe. But I'm just trying to cut it down a little bit. But you could actually just put straight sweet heat for your meat on it and it'd be just as good. You want to make sure you chop up all the little balls of brown sugar, because you don't want you want it to be consistently mixed. I'm going to try something a little bit different now. I'm going to actually lay the fish out and take my mixture and sprinkle it. And what that'll do is actually sprinkle it, and that'll keep my mixture from becoming very liquidy, like it did in the last little bit of fish I did. Might be able to throw some of these pieces out on there. Kind of rub it on the fish. I really don't know which way is better, guys, so do it how you feel. However you feel like doing it, just go with it. Just get it all. Make sure it's evenly coated on there. And if the fish is a little damp, it'll actually help it to stick, so. Alright, so all of our fish is ready. It's ready to go on the smoker. Let me go check the smoker and see. Alright, so like I was saying, these cookie trays, what are really good about them, you can literally take them. Set them right on the grill. Also, I have a super smoke feature on mine, and what that does, it actually gives it more smoke flavor. So I'm going to turn that on for a little bit and let it get a nice good temperature. It's going to sit on that smoker for about 5 hours, so you can either sit here and wait and watch it, or we can just come back later. And it's starting to rain, but we're going to take a peek. Ooh, ooh. Yeah, look at it. Alright, so it's been on the grill at 180 for about 3.5-4 hours, and these thinner pieces, I believe, are actually done. Smoke's not that bad, sorry about that. Like I said, these thinner pieces are done, so we're gonna take them off. Spin this around because there's some spots on the grill that actually cook faster.
So I took a little bit off the grill. I'm tasting, test tasting, so stay tuned. Alright, so these have been on there for about 5.5-6 hours. And you can see the trout fillets I got here are almost done. The catfish still got a little bit bounce to them, but the ends here are... I think what I'm going to actually do is I have a dehydrator. I'm going to take the dehydrator and put the thicker pieces in the dehydrator and let it finish that way. But like, look at this. Like, I just want to show that. Makes a pretty grid pattern on with them cookie drying racks. But and the little bit of Rio that I had, this is actual jerky. Oh. So, I'm not a big fish person. I love specks and all. But, definitely. Definitely. Alright, so a few of these pieces, such as these, this trout here, is definitely done. I mean, look at that. It literally looks like beef jerky you would buy at the store. Which is fish. Healthy for you, right? Just kind of pressing on it to see. That might have to go. I have to dehydrate a little bit more, but I'm gonna take these off and actually refrigerate them. So I just want to let you know, Benny, the trout was better than the Rios I let you try. Sorry, dude. Alright, so you've seen me try all the other two, so here's a piece of catfish. It's good. Definitely gonna do this again, guys. That catfish, I actually think I'm gonna throw on the dehydrator inside. I'll show you how that works. For a couple hours, just pull some more of that juice out, but it's good. Definitely recommend this. I just plugged it in. That's the first set. Let's see. What are you doing? And all we're trying to do at this point is just pull a little bit more of that moisture out of this fish to make it more of a what you would think of as a jerky. But if you've ever had Rouse's chicken jerky, currently that is the condition that these are in. So I don't think it'll be too much longer in the dehydrator. But gonna go do some stuff, come back and check on it. All right, so it's been on here for a few hours. And you can see it's actually very jerky like now. Gonna I might actually leave these on, because what I'm looking at is here, somehow still feel how kind of soft it is. I kind of want to crisp it up a little bit more, but like this piece here,
is very much jerky-like.
All right, so these have been overnight now. And you can actually see they are just like jerky. There you go. That's how you do it.
I definitely thought the trout and the Rios were way better than the catfish, but I'm not a big catfish person. I'll eat it fried, I'll eat it. But if I had to, if you gave me the choice between trout and catfish anyway, I would definitely choose trout. The Rios were good. First time I ever cooked a Rio. Make sure they got a little bit of size to them. But remember, in Louisiana, you have to take them out the water and kill them. It is against the law to keep them alive. Get out there, get fishing, experiment. You know, that was an experiment. I think it turned out okay. People liked it. I'm going to keep trying to see if I can figure out a better recipe. Make sure you find the sweet heat for your meat. Put it in the link in the description below. Probably one of the, if you like sweet heat, that's the way to go. The only reason I was cutting it like I was to give it a little bit more sweetness to the jerky, and because I didn't have enough sweet heat for your meat to make all of that jerky, so cutting it actually helped out. But one tip I would recommend when making the jerky would be to make like a baste with it. Basically mix it all up in the water. I'm going to even next time try to marinate it. This was kind of a I wanted to make it today thing and didn't think about it. So I'm going to try making a baste next time. I'll make another video on it. If you have any comments or questions, leave them in the description below. Anything you'd like to see, let us know. You can find us on Facebook, Instagram, and even TikTok at Louisiana Outdoors. TikTok's the only one that don't have the experience on it because they don't like long names, but hey. Leave a link in the description below for this nifty hat. You know, I kind of like, I like dealing with small businesses. That's why you'll see me a lot of times. If I see a small business has something, I'll do it. I bought a line cutter's ring before they knew who they were. This company here, I followed them on Instagram. Next thing I know, I was getting a message saying they appreciated me following them. So, I'm going to leave a link to their Instagram, Facebook, and their website in the link below. Go check them out, and have a good day.